Both quarterbacks have reliable tight ends they know they'll be able to count on to make plays. It's Travis Kelce's Chiefs going up against Gronkowski's Patriots. With that, it's time to hook up with our commentators in the booth. So we turn it over to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, we are about an hour's drive southwest of downtown Boston in the area known as Patriot Place, Gillette Stadium, here in Foxborough. A moment ago, the pride of Massachusetts, the Patriots, introduced to this, as always, sold-out crowd as they get set to go head-to-head with the Kansas City Chiefs. Hello again, everybody. I'm Brandon Godden here in the booth with, as always, Charles Davis. Charles, a lot of times in the open, we focus on quarterbacks, running backs. What about the tight ends in this one?
Well, I think LR identified it really well because the tight ends are matchup nightmares nowadays. Who are you going to cover them with? Because really, they are pumped up wide receivers who can flat out run and use their body to create bigger plays. Cover them with a linebacker, cover them with a defensive back. Either way, they feel like they have the advantage.
Steven Goskowski now has this one teed up, and we are underway from Gillette Stadium. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. So here come the Chiefs for their opening drive. They'll be led out by the number one overall selection back in 05 out of the University of Utah. It's Alex Smith.
And head coach Andy Reid has said even with Patrick Mahomes being picked number 10 in the draft overall, people think he's going to replace him. Alex Smith is our guy, and he should be. Third in the league in the number of wins behind only Tom Brady and Aaron Rodgers since 2011.
Now a first down throw. It's Smith. And he's going to dump this off to his running back, Hunt. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Give him 13 yards there and a Kansas City first down.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody cut. Oh, he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. So the offense has it first and 10. They go play action here on first down. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. A gain of 6 there on first. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. A shotgun snap for Smith. On target over the middle to Hill. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A Kansas City first down. Smith finding Hill that time. First carry now for Kareem Hunt. Room to run inside the 40. And he's going to go out of bounds at the 30-yard line. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first.
That outside handoff to the left, that play has to warm the heart of an offensive line coach because they controlled the left side where they were supposed to, but they didn't allow anything to leak from the backside on the right side of the offensive line either. Well played.
Yeah, and it created a big run. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. They'll run again with Hunt, and he'll fall forward to the 29-yard line. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine. This is the offense we're going to see coming up in this one, and Travis Kelce will be key.
What a tremendous weapon he is, especially in the red zone. Knows how to find the end zone when running his routes.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Smith with a give to Hunt. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
Count me as a little bit surprised by what we just saw there, because this has been a pretty long drive. And normally you think that wears down a defense. In this case, looked like the offensive line let them down a little bit.
They allowed the penetration and the ability to stuff them for a loss. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Throwing is Smith. And it's complete to Kelce. And they do get him down, but not before he reaches the four-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4-for-4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it, because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
And now a first down following that long gain. To throw is Smith. But he lost six there on the first down play. And the offense behind the chains here, a touch on second and 11. Now it's Smith. And he's got it. Touchdown, Chiefs. Demetrius Harris, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Chiefs take it right down and score on the opening drive.
I do believe we came here to see a game, didn't we? And it looks like he's running what we call routes versus air. You just go out there with your offensive unit and throw the football with no defense. He's 5-for-5 on the opening drive.
He was on his game there for drive number one, but my only thing is now he can't go any higher than that. He was so perfect. Can he do it again later?
Yeah, all he cares about right now is making it 10-for-10, 15-for-15.
Keeping that going.
And he feels like he can get it done.
So that drive consumes 9 plays all told, and it's capped off with a Kansas City touchdown. Santos out now. He'll kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. So now the Patriots getting set to take over on offense. The man under center leading them, now 40 years of age in his 18th year out of Michigan, the great Tom Brady.
And we keep hearing from people who are waiting to see the drop-off in his play. I'd quit worrying about it. I'd quit looking for it. He says he wants to play until he's 45. Is there any reason to doubt him? His skills have shown no sign of declining.
Go, 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 go. carry for the shifty Deion Lewis. And he's not even going to get back to the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
But when it comes to the running game, the New England Patriots, they're one of the few teams in the NFL that I don't think care much about balancing things out.
Last year, to your point, fifth in passing yardage, number 30 in the run game.
What they want to do each and every week is make a game plan based on their opponent, not so much their own personnel, and they try to attack that way.
Try again with Lewis. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain that time, but it leaves him with third and 11 coming up. And now we take a peek at the Patriot offense.
We all know it takes excellent players in order to have a great team in the NFL. But in New England, there's a system and there's a belief on how they do things on offense. And for them, the word is balance. And that is hard to do in today's NFL. They don't lean on the run or lean on the pass week in and week out. They just game plan for where they think the defense is going to be weak and tune that up for each and every game.
Throwing is Brady on third down. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. 18 big yards on that one, and a New England first down.
I know at the end of games, coaches always tell us there's no one play, won or lost a game. But this seems pretty important early, doesn't it? Their ability to pick up that first down on third down, I thought that was key.
Well, you're already in the hole after the touchdown on the other side. How will you respond? We talk about that a lot. And they responded pretty well there. You go three and out, I think you give up a lot of momentum. You get down two scores, could be an entirely different game.
So they've got a nice drive going now. They're in good shape. What's interesting to me is they're also in that spot of the field where you would take a shot. Do you change that up just because you're down a touchdown?
Here's Brady. And pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. And a glance now at the Chiefs' defense.
Ranking 24th overall in total defense is not something that excites Kansas City, but they offset that in a big way in 2016. They forced 33 turnovers, which led the league by three, and ended up plus 16 in turnover margin, which tied for first in the NFL, which helped lead them to a playoff run.
Offense still needing 10 yards, second down. To throw again, Brady, and incomplete there. A nice hit, jars the ball free, and brings up third down.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And an extra DB here for the Chiefs on third down.
Pass situation.
On play action, it's Brady. And he's taken down, a Chiefs sack. Oh, free safety blitz, that can be a gamble, but it proves fruitful there.
Yeah, you're exactly right about the gamble, because oftentimes the free safety is the last line of defense against a long pass. And when he comes at the quarterback, he'd better get home and make the play. Otherwise, a big play could result for the offense.
In his fifth year from La Tech, here's the lefty Ryan Allen to punt it. Back deep for Kansas City, DeAnthony Thomas. Yeah, he was looking for the checkup bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. And let's shift now to talking about the Patriots' defense. And it's the first quarter, but they gave up the score last time. How important is it here not to fall two scores behind?
Extremely important, because not only are you trying to avoid being in a big deficit to start this game off, you also want to get into a pattern where that offense has the advantage. You've got to find a way to turn things around. This is the series to begin that.
Yeah, we'll see if they can keep them off the scoreboard here for a second time. First down, Smith. It's Kelce on the ground. That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass on the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to float this one deep right side. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Patrick Chung. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a second and 3, second and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
First down with Deion Lewis. A nice move gets him a few extra. Down just shy of his 20. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and 2. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
Now Brady throwing on second down, and the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Third down, it's Lewis, and he'll get this one across the 20, but only up to about the 21. 2 yards on the pickup there, it's fourth down.
Fourth and short, partner. I mean, this would be a really risky call. Here we are in the first quarter.
On your own side of the field.
But boy, what a tone setter that would be to go for it and get it, wouldn't it?
You're gritty today, I like it.
I'm feeling it.
Here's Ryan Allen now, on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Here's Thomas. Oh, eluding the tackle. And he's going to be run over. Hit hard as he'll be marked down. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. To begin the drive, here's a handoff to Hunt. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, add that play to his resume, Real, because he went to the Pro Bowl last year. That's how you go to the Pro Bowl. You make plays like that, big-time penetration, and throw people for losses.
Stay on the ground again. It's Hunt, and they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. He lost two there, and it's third down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs, and let's face it, they know how to finish plays too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them. An extra corner on the field for New England here on third down.
Yeah, another DB. From the gun, here's Smith. The tight end Kelce has it over the middle. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Great coverage there. Holds him to a 2-yard return following a 50-yard punt. And the Pats will be backed up deep to get the drive started as they take over first and 10. The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field.
And this is their third drive. Maybe the focus right now not so much on points, but getting their first down.
And when you start off a game, you don't even think that's an issue, do you? But you go a drive, a second drive, no first down, that becomes an issue. Now you got to think about, okay, what type of play calling do I have to do to get us in a spot to pick that first one up?
Brady now on first down. It's hauled in by Brandon Cooks. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 14 yards is the pickup there, and a New England first down. Fresh set of downs here. Throwing on first down is Brady. And an alley to run. And avoids the contact by sliding. It'll be a gain of 9, and that'll make it second and short. Second and just one. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. At the end of one, 7-0 is our score. And we'll return to Foxborough after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. Again, a
it's Lewis. And shedding through the tackle, extending the arm.
Oh, yes, it works.
18 big yards on that one, and a New England first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, last drive, they went three and out.
Brady gives this one to Lewis. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Is Lewis. Oh, and Lewis lost the football.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home, the next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. New England on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. From the gun, it's Brady. Toward the sideline, and he will have the first down as he was able to keep the feet in bounds. The Patriots pick up the first down, Brady to Amendola.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe-tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
On first down, Brady. To the sideline, wow, what a catch. Doesn't get a lot out of it. But he is able to keep the feet in bounds. That throw good for 4. It's 2nd down.
He was a cover guy for Madden in 2016, but I don't think Gronk saw that as being his highlight for the year. What did he have, 25 catches for the season? Only 8 games went down for good right before Thanksgiving. You know he wants to be back with a vengeance in 2017.
Brady to throw on 2nd down. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Mitchell. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does. And the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Now flags come in. Looked like one of the Patriots might have moved.
False start, offense.
And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back 5.
Still 1st down.
Brady again. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. That's good for a gain of six, second and goal. Instead of the running back in New England, sometimes they like to call him the passing back. So they get him the ball in different ways, don't they?
They certainly do. Think about the ones they've had in recent vintage. You talk about Kevin Faulk, Danny Woodhead, Shane Vereen. James White could have been the MVP in the Super Bowl if it wasn't for a certain quarterback that was on the field that day.
Now Lewis. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the five down to the three.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed. And this offense on third down today, they've hit two for four thus far. They're looking at a third and goal here. Now flags come in. Looked like one of the Patriots might have moved.
Foster, offense.
That was a third and somewhat manageable, now not so manageable.
Exactly, because you had a play call on that you felt like, hey, this could go quick, and it doesn't take much to get it done. Now, you got to start thinking about a little bit of a deeper route type of a call, especially if you want to throw it.
They're back at the eight now, third and goal. Now Brady. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. Tom Mahaly in there to drop him for a loss of 10. And it'll be fourth and long.
Well, that's the second time they've gotten to Brady, and you've got to do it a variety of ways. You want your regular pressure. Sometimes you have to bring extra. But in this case, they got to him, and that just doesn't happen very often.
It's a rarity. He's just such a veteran. His pocket presence so good. But, hey, tip of the cap to the D. So on fourth down, Brady will yield to Gostkowski for the field goal try. From the right hash, it's a 35-yard attempt. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So they get three. They were hoping for six, an unlucky number 13 play drive.
Well, you go to the sideline after putting 3 points on the board, happy. But you wanted to be ecstatic. You wanted to have six on the board. On the opposite sideline, though, the defense, I think they're high-fiving each other, only giving up three after letting them run that much offense.
Gostkowski now converted for three. Now he'll kick this one away. This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer. Create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. They'll start with Hunt on the ground. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. But at least he was able to break that initial contact, or it could have been a loss.
Yeah, give credit to the defensive player, though. What did he do? Made him slow down, slow up his feet, and allowed the rest of the guys to get there to finish him off.
Now a play fake, and it's Smith. And that is intercepted. Or was it? Wait, they'll say no. No interception. He did not keep the feet in bounds, apparently. So that's just going to be an incompletion. All right, Charles, as a former defensive back, how disheartening to actually catch it but just not be able to stay in bounds there defensively.
Well, extremely, because you know the rap against us defenders is that we're frustrated offensive guys who can't catch. And he caught it, just couldn't get his feet down in bounds. It's that second part that finished off the play for him.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
But no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
Here's Dustin Colquitt now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Here's Jones, fights him off, and able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt, and the Patriots take over. So the Patriots coming out now. And a methodical drive last time, but they couldn't get that knockout blow. They had to settle for three.
But you gotta like what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blows, the setup punch. As you said, they didn't get the knockout blow here, but that doesn't mean it can't come later in the game on another possession. And the defense on the other side,
maybe a little gas,
yeah,
right?
A little tired. And if nothing else, they just feel relieved getting upfield and giving up three. They don't exactly feel like they've handled the offense.
And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. Only a gain of a yard there, but it indeed gets him a new set of downs.
I know what you're thinking out there. I know a lot of you are thinking, take a shot downfield. It's a great spot for it. I'd say maybe later in the game, definitely in the second half. But right now, I think they were just trying to get some momentum built. Get a first down, pick it up, and keep moving.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. Not much there, maybe a couple up to the 35.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it, because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Under four to go now as the clock runs, and they come up on second down. This is Lewis. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
If you're the coaching staff upstairs, you might want to file that play away. Did you see how fast the safety closed on that one? Coming up in run support, made a big-time tackle. Might want to try and check into a pass next time.
Yeah, got him for a loss. Really, really great play defensively. New England on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and 10. Now flags come in. Looked like one of the Patriots might have moved.
False start, offense.
And that'll set them back 5.
Still third down.
New England on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be third and 15. Working from the gun, it's Brady. Got a man, it's Amendola. And he's got the first down as he's up to the 45-yard line. It'll be a Patriot first down on a pickup of 16.
My next teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks, because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going
to ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, ah, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Brady now on first down. Allen's got it over the middle, and he's brought down. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
Martellus Bennett moves on to Green Bay, so what do the Patriots do? They go get Dwayne Allen from Indianapolis.
Yeah, for a fourth-round draft pick, and last year he had 35 catches, 6 touchdowns as a Colt. And also the Patriots got Brandon Cooks, Coney Ealy, and Allen all for draft picks. First and 10, here's Brady. Got a man complete, it's Chris Hogan. And he's gonna get this inside the 30. 11 more on that one and another first down. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back to Foxborough after this. When halftime rolls around in just a bit, we'll send you to Orlando. You will hear the dulcet tones of Mr. Larry Ridley with our EA Sports halftime report.
Does dulcet mean good?
Yeah, it's just something that broadcasters say. It's got to be good, right?
It's got to be
good. You tell me.
Well, it's got to be good if Larry's doing it.
First and 10, Brady. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. A gain of 6 there on first.
If you run an out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Second down now after the pass completion. Now flags come in. Look like one of the Patriots might have moved.
False start, offense.
So that'll back him up 5.
Still second down.
Again, it's Brady. Sets up the screen to Lewis. And a nice little quick spin move before he's dropped. And a pretty good gain. Give him 9 yards on the second down screen play.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
The offense on third down tonight, they've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. Brady going to try and throw on third down. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. But he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defense side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
Now flags come in. Looked like one of the Patriots might have moved.
False start, offense.
That's going to set him back 5 yards.
Still first down.
And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. Again, they'll throw with Brady. Amendola catching it left side. And before the second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. Throw again. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Brandon Cooks. A 5-yard touchdown. And the Pats able to cash in for 6.
And while that touchdown does not give them an insurmountable lead, it's still a lead, and that always feels good to a team.
They'd love to take that into the lockers, but a little time left on that clock, so some work to do.
I like that. I like how you're guarding against a letdown there.
Already looking forward.
Coaching them up from right up here in the booth.
And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. So that drive, 12 plays in length, and it ends with a New England touchdown. Koskowski now out to kick it away. To return, here's Chris Conley. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. The New England defense gearing up to take the field. They were able to force the 3-and-out last time, led to the punt, and then led to a touchdown for their crew. So they'll be looking for a little bit more of that, Charles.
Well, I think that they created the spark with the 3-and-out. Gave a little momentum to their offense. They said, all right, appreciate it, guys. And they took the ball downfield and stuck it in the end zone.
And that defense wasn't out there long. They'll be trying to keep it short here. Smith on first down. Complete. The tight end, Kelsey. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. As they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. Second and 5. Back to throw, Smith. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Smith. And able to find Conley. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Now a first down throw. It's Smith. He's going to dump this off to his running back, Hunt. 7 yards on the play, and it's a second down. Smith trying to get him to the line quickly with the clock rolling. Smith throwing again. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
Smith on third down. Ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by Daron Harmon. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
Start the drive on the ground with Lewis. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. So we've reached halftime here at Gillette Stadium with the Patriots on top. As we send you down to Orlando, where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry.
All right, Brandon, back to you and Charles in a bit. But first, let's get you caught up on all the highlights from the first half. The Patriots are up right now and are looking to keep up the pressure moving forward. The Chiefs didn't play their best, and they'll need to be at their best now to come back. All right, let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Chiefs heading out on their opening drive. Kelce's wide open here on the catch, and he'll make it all the way down to the 4-yard line before being tackled. Chiefs now later on the drive. Harris has got nobody around him on the catch, and he'd cap off the 9-play drive with a TD. Now to late in the second, as they take a 7-0 lead. Brady's going to complete the pass, and he'll end up at their own 45-yard line before being tackled. Staying late in the half, Brady hooking up with Brandon Cooks, and he cap off the long drive with a TD. That puts them up by a field goal. Second half still to come. Let's get back up to Foxborough with Brandon and Charles.
Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And a couple yards deep, he'll go to a knee. He won't return it, and they'll take it out to the 25. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. Start off with a give to Lewis. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
And that play was vintage Derek Johnson. Made a play in the backfield. In college, he did as an outside linebacker. Used speed to get to the backfield. Now, a bulked-up inside linebacker with multiple Pro Bowls on his resume.
And the offense will be looking to get at least some of this yardage back here. It's second and 12. Shotgun now for Brady. Goes right side, complete to Gronk. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. 23 yards on the play. Ah, yes, Brady to Gronk. You think these two are in sync?
Without a doubt. And look, they both understand what they can do for each other. Gronk knows if he gets open, the ball's going to be there. And Tom Brady knows what a great security blanket Gronk is. When all else fails, you find Big 87.
Well, the offense lining up first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. A gain of three, second down.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. On second down, here's Brady. Over the middle, that's taken in by Gronkowski. And he'll get it down here to the 43. Brady to Gronkowski for the Patriot first down.
Brandon, with the way things are going with Tom Brady finding Gronk as many times as he has in this game and the team is winning, you think at some point maybe even Brady would do the Gronk dance?
Well, if he does that Gronk dance, Davis, that means you have to do that Gronk dance.
Trust me, partner. No one wants to see me do the Gronk dance.
Your wife?
No. No one.
Here to his running back. That one good for 13 and a New England first down.
Well, that's the desired outcome coming out here in the second half of being able to run the football and establish a little bit of pace and maybe even a bit of dominance at the line of scrimmage. They want that to continue. Way too early to think about this being ball control time, but the way they're running it, you got to think they may want to continue that and see if they can go ahead and grind their opponents into submission.
Offensive line wasn't set. There's the flag, and 5 yards back they go.
Quarterback has to look around and make sure that his team is ready to go. Sometimes the quarterbacks go faster than is necessary.
Still first down.
So the penalty by the offense, and now they face a first and 15. And he'll give it here to his running back. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. It'll be a loss of one, and it'll be a second and long.
Well, partner, I guess sometimes it's just a matter of philosophy. Some say run it until they absolutely stop you, and others say, well, when you think they're about to stop you, fool them a little bit. I guess they should have tried to fool them on that play.
This is James White. And some space here. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. James White, 36 yards. And the Patriots add on to their lead. A good, sustained drive there in this third quarter, capping it off with a touchdown to give them a nice two-score advantage.
It was actually a fun one to watch, wasn't it? I mean, for me, seeing the mix of what they did, how they moved the ball downfield, very sharp, too. Each and every play seemed to be executed with great dispatch.
Gostkowski for the point after. It's good to make it 17-7. So that a 7-play, 80-yard drive. And the finishing touch was that nice long run into the end zone. Gostkowski now out to kick it away. This is taken at his 4. Oh, look at the juke. Then he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
They'll begin the drive with Hunt. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They go play action here on first down. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at second down.
So this is what happens when you throw interceptions, that confident veneer that you have. It's chipped away a little bit. Maybe a little bit gun-shy throwing it around.
Yeah, under-throwing him there, and you're right. Those interceptions may be in the back of his mind. On second and 10, Smith. To the sideline, and wow, what a catch there. He doesn't get a lot, but he was able to get the feet down complete. It'll be a pickup of just 2, and that's going to bring up a third down.
Was that a receiver? Yeah, actually it was. It was a running back who was a receiver on the play. Ike's been spending time in the receiver drills getting his feet down.
Well, those guys out of the backfield, they got to be good, agile with their feet. He showed the agility there with a toe tap.
No doubt about it. It's like he'd gone to ballet school. Got the toes down and stayed in bounds.
Smith now to throw, and that is incomplete.
into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. Here's Dustin Colquitt now as he's on to punt for Kansas City. And that hits at the six and carries into the end zone for a touchback. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. It doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Throwing on first down is Brady. It's caught outright, Amendola. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Time to the tailback, and he'll get this up only to about the 33. 2 yards on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it, because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Looking right, and they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. So here we go, first and 10 now. Now a handoff here to his running back, and he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now they'll throw with Brady. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
New England on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This will be 3rd and 6. Throwing is Brady on third down. And Cooks has it over the middle. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45. Brady to his new signee Cooks, and the Patriots able to convert on third down. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme. and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and 11.
That was a nice play by the defense, but the offense can't let that one play define them. Let it go, move on, and start over again.
Ready to throw on second down. Looking left sideline, incomplete. His tight end, Dwayne Allen, the intended receiver. And it's third down.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
New England on third down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This is third and 11. Now Brady. Now he'll let it go deep left side. This is caught inside the 15. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now in Foxborough. We get set for the fourth quarter. Patriots have the lead. They also have the football. Now this will be the ninth play on this drive. First down, Brady. Goes underneath here to White. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. Nice job defensively to hold him to 4, and now it's second and goal.
As we well know, James White was an absolute man in the Super Bowl. But, boy, his regular season wasn't bad either. Had 60 catches.
60 catches, more than Martellus Bennett, more than Chris Hogan, something that went overlooked in his arsenal. Long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. 6 yards still to go here on second and goal. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation, and taking care of the football, paramount, and he got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball. The offense on third down, 6 conversions and 9 tries. They've done a great job of picking these up. This is third and goal. From the gun, it's Brady. Caught by Amendola. Patriot touchdown. Danny Amendola, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Patriots add 6 to their lead. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic, but usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever, there it results in a touchdown. The point after try for Gostkowski. And that'll make this a 3-score game as the lead moves to 17. That one in the books as a 12-play drive, and it's finished off by a Pats touchdown. Gaskowski now out to kick it away. This will be taken in at the one. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. And out come the Chiefs now. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him. All right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But so, hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
First down, it's Smith. On target over the middle to Hill. A gain of six there on first. Decent start to the drive, but let's face it, they need a lot of things to go right in a short amount of time, down three scores.
Yeah, they're going to run their two-minute offense here in this game, but this is for future games. Can they get better and be ready for the next time, hopefully with a chance to win?
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. To throw on second down is Smith. To the right side, it's Kelce. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A good pickup there of 20 yards. Fifth catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, and the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. Used to be occasional, right? Safety valve, throw one to him every so often, but mainly they want him out there to block. Nowadays, an integral part of the passing game, and they create such great mismatches that they often become the leading receiver.
On first down, Smith. Connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. His favorite target, Travis Kelce, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Now a play fake, and it's Smith. Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. Albert Wilson, the intended receiver there, and it's third down.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. The Chiefs on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 10. Throwing on third down, Smith. And it's complete to Kelce. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism. Great hand-eye coordination. Guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Again, Smith. His throw incomplete. Kareem Hunt is running back, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
Well, partner, so much for the mismatch. How about the guy at the second level, that big linebacker, able to run with the receiver and make a play on the football?
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. Here's Smith, throwing again. And he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10.
personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
So give them the yardage on the pass and half the distance to the goal line.
Because they're inside the 30, so now you don't march off the full 15, right? You have half the distance to the goal. In any event, that's precious real estate given up.
First down and goal. The offense knocking on the door. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. A great effort there. A 6-yard touchdown run. And the Chiefs are able to cut into this lead. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there. And they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how are we going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
It's up and good, so they claw back into it, 24-14 now. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And Kareem Hunt, the one to finish it off, as he did so with a touchdown run. Santos out now. He'll kick it away. Now Deion Lewis to return. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. And now out come the Patriots. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he powers his way up past the 30. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
The old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
And Gronkowski's got it, complete over the middle. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. The familiar refrain, Brady to Gronk for the New England first. Defensively, they're okay with that. Short little route, tackle him inbounds. Okay.
All right, cliche alert. It's time for someone to make a play, because they've got to have something bigger downfield. They can't just take what they give them. They've got to force it and make something big happen for them.
They'll run with White. And no room that time. Getting it to about the 46. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. Offensively, with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Yeah, think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock.
It'll be a pickup of 5, and that leaves them with 5 more. 3rd and 5 now. The 4th quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
From the gun on third down, Brady. And he's got a man open. That's Allen. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. Brady to his new tight end, Allen, for a Patriot first. And defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. Look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
So the offense has it first and 10. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. That's gonna go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Now a handoff here to his running back. So a good spin move there before he's taken down. A nice little game. And now right out of the 2 minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. All right, so the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. New England on third down. They've had plenty of success. 8 conversions, looking for a 9th. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. So it'll be first down here after the run. And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. That'll be their 3rd and final stoppage here as we step aside. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. Second down, 8. Here to his running back, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 4 yards on the pickup there, as it'll leave him with a 3rd and about 4 more for a 1st.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
Now Brady. Got a man. It's Amendola. And for the moment, this will be a first down. But we have a marker on the field. Let's see if this stands.
Illegal block in the back. Offense.
So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
This offense has converted two third downs on this drive already. This is third and four. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. Call it a four-yard pickup, but it leaves him a few inches short here on fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This will be a 37-yard attempt. And Gostkowski's kick is good. And that will stretch the lead up to 13. So they settle for just the three there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the fourth.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the final nail. But three does give them some breathing room and lets them build up a little cushion.
Gostkowski now converted for three. Now he'll kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Smith on first down. He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Snags it for the pick, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Obviously disappointing, but you had to go for broke here, down two scores. So that forced you to make some throws you definitely wouldn't want to make. But I think this interception is going to pretty much write an end to this one.
And this looks to probably be the final play. Brady will take a knee here, and that should just about do it. And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Patriots, winners here at home, as we say so long.